Hey guys, what is up? Welcome to my channel. So for today's video, I am going to be reviewing the brand new Dominique Cosmetics Rustic Glam Eyeshadow Palette. So if you're interested in hearing my thoughts on this palette, as well as seeing some swatches, and of course the look on my eyes right now, then just keep watching. Dominique Cosmetics has released her fourth eyeshadow palette in her line. Now, her eyeshadow palettes are the only thing that I've ever bought from her brand. I haven't bought any of her highlighters or her lip products, and with this palette, she also came out with some brushes. Did not purchase those, I just purchased the palette. I picked this up in stores at Sephora a couple days after it released. I originally wasn't going to purchase this palette, and then I saw it in person, and I was like, never mind, I want it. So let's just go into the major details of this palette. It is $44. You can get it right now at Sephora and of course the Dominique Cosmetics website. It is described as a day to night 12 pan eyeshadow palette to help you create a variety of looks from neutral, smoked out to fierce and glam. So the packaging of this one is, oh my gosh, so beautiful. It has Rustic Glam Dominique Cosmetics embroidered in like gold, and it's just super pretty. I think this is very unique packaging. If we're just being a regular square kind of cardboard casing, the design on it is so beautiful. So you open it up and you're getting a mirror that's pretty decent size. I think it could be bigger. I know they wanted to go with that shape, but it could have been bigger. I know how some of us feel about mirrors. And then of course you're going to reveal your 12 eyeshadow shades. In here there's a mixture of textures. Generally speaking, you're getting 9 mattes and 3 shimmers. 2 of those mattes though do have micro glitters in them, but the base of it is matte. This is described as a day to night palette, and I would definitely agree with that. What I really like about this palette is that there are such a variety of colors, so you can create that day to night look, just a different variety of looks as well. I really like the layout of the palette, so honestly you can pair the top and bottom colors together and it would create a beautiful look. You have a pink and purple look, a blue smoky eye, a green eye, you could do something with this orange. Blue and bronze always looks really good together, and then you have some matte colors. Then you have more of a neutral eye kind of in this area. So I do think the layout of this palette is really nice. I think that the ratio of mattes to shimmers is really nice. And at first this palette didn't call out to me just because I thought the arrangement of colors was a little bit odd, but the more that I looked at it, the more inspired that I felt by this palette. You can just create so many different kinds of looks, you guys have no idea. So let's talk about the formulation of this palette. If you do not like a more powdery, loose, packed formula, you will not like this formula. Her mattes especially are, they do have quite a lot of kickback. I personally don't prefer a formula that has a ton of kickback, but if it works and it blends and it's not patchy, I'm okay with it. I think her matte formula is really nice. I had originally fallen in love with Dominique Cosmetics with her latte palette. I thought that that palette was amazing. It's one of my favorites. I think just because she has such unique colors in here, not all of the formulas are amazing. Some shades are better than others. So I'm just going to talk about her matte formula right now. Generally speaking, this is a very good matte formula. Like I said, very loosely packed, very soft. Some shades are much more soft in consistency than others. For example, Evil Eye, Free Spirit, Desert Queen Cactus, and Dreamcatcher. All of these guys in this area I noticed to be incredibly soft. I feel like if this had a rough travel, those shades would break. Especially Free Spirit, it's almost chalky feeling. It is that loosely packed. I personally don't mind because I do just like to use this as kind of a base color or underneath my brows. So it's a little bit more messy than I personally would prefer. Desert Queen as well is one of those extremely soft shades. Another shade worth talking about is Cactus. This one was not my favorite. Tone-wise and shade-wise, this is actually my favorite matte in the palette. I think it is so unique. It's kind of like a seafoam aqua, and it is so gorgeous, but it can run a little bit patchy. It's not the worst shadow in the world, that's for sure. You can kind of build onto it to make it not patchy anymore, so it is workable, but Just be aware upon initial application, this may come out a little bit patchy, but it can be fixed. Dreamcatcher and Moonchild, they do have microfine glitters in them that may or may not show up depending on how you use them. If you use Dreamcatcher all over your crease, you're not going to get those glitter particles, but if you pack it on, you will see it. Same thing with Moonchild. The glitter particles are much more noticeable in the pan, but I have it in my outer corner. You can't even tell there's any glitters in it. I did pack this on over my eyeliner, however, and you could see little blue flecks, but personally that doesn't bother me at all. Which, by the way, Moonchild right here is a really great shade. For the most part, I really do like the mattes on here. I think they blend super easily, they're super soft, they're very pigmented, and they're buildable. I think at some point some shades may be a little bit more crumbly than I would prefer, which makes them a tad bit harder to work with, but they're a good formula, especially for these more weird colors up here. It's a good formula. I do want to talk about her shimmers. Personally, I don't think the shimmer formula is as good as in her latte palette. For some reason, there was a couple shades in the latte palette where her shimmer formula just killed it. Gypsy right here, I really do not like this shade too much. While it is beautiful on the lid, it's one of those shades that is extremely powdery, and it kind of separates on your eye and it doesn't really melt into your skin or glide onto your skin. This is that shade that you really have to be careful with and press into the skin. It doesn't look very uniform on your lid. You can kind of see those pigment particles separating. You can work it into your lid, no problem, and it does look okay. This shade does require a little bit of extra work. I would recommend using it on top of a glitter glue, or maybe even using it wet is gonna make the shade work. But yeah, this one, it falls apart and crumbles, so just be careful when using this one. Wonderlust is definitely my favorite shimmer in this palette. It is what is on the inner half of my lid. Super beautiful. You're definitely going to get a very metallic kick when you use the shade wet. Bohemian, I do like. I was a bit underwhelmed with it just because I felt like it did fall a little bit flat. I have so many bronzes that show up much more reflective and give off so much more payoff than this shade does. This one I had to kind of build up to get my desired opacity and shine, and I was surprised by this because usually this company does a great job with these types of shades, but yeah, I was a little bit underwhelmed with that shade. With the exception of Gypsy, this is a really good palette formula. Formulation-wise, I do enjoy it, and for $44 and the amount of product you're getting, I do think it's worth it. And though this palette may look intimidating at first, it's not laid out in a way that's just going to be confusing. If you look at it, you can really see the different types of looks you can create. You can create a neutral eye, you can create a blue eye, a green eye, kind of what I have going on right now. This purple and pink would be beautiful. You can just really go in a lot of different directions with this palette, and I didn't see it at first, but when I really looked at it, I was like, wow, this palette is very unique. I have been creating some looks with it over the past couple of days. I've been sticking with more of the neutral colors, but for my look today, I did want to do kind of a crazy fun look. So here is how I got this look. So I started off with the shade Free Spirit right here, and I just used that to set underneath my brow and kind of that base light color underneath there. I then went in with the shade Cactus, which is that color you will see kind of comes off a little bit patchy at first, but it can easily be remedied. It looks fine after you work with it, just with a second layer. So I really like Cactus. Like I said, it's my favorite matte shade and it's very unique. And then I went in with the shade Moonchild and I just packed that onto the outer corner of my eyelid. I decided I wanted to make a smoky eye today. So I packed that on and I blended it. This was a very easy color to work with. And then I finished off with the shade Wonderlust right here. And I used my finger initially to apply, and though that worked, I found that this actually applied really well with a flat shader brush, and then I did wet my brush at the end just to kind of give it that extra punch to the eyelid. And on my lower lash line, I basically kind of repeated what I did on the top on the bottom, and I put on lashes and liner and all of that. So if you are curious about anything else that I'm wearing, it will be in the description box. But I'm so obsessed with this look, and it's insane the different types of looks that I can get with this palette. I can go in complete different directions, and you wouldn't have guessed that they were just all from this palette. So I think if you're wanting to add something a little bit more different to your collection, or if you're wanting to experiment with some shadows and just create different kinds of looks than you're more comfortable with normally, I think that this is a great palette to go with because you can create neutral everyday looks. This is very encouraging of playing outside the box a little bit and doing something you're not normally used to. So I do like this palette a lot. Is it my favorite palette from Dominique Cosmetics? No, I love her latte palette so much, and I really enjoy her berries and cream as well, but I do think this is a very nice, unique palette out on the market right now. There really isn't one at the moment out with this color story, so yeah, I don't regret purchasing it. If you are interested in buying this palette and this color story interests you, you won't be disappointed. It's a very nice formula, and it's also supporting a really nice and lovely business owner as well. So anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this review. I hope you found it helpful. Let me know down below if you pick this guy up or if you are thinking of it, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye guys, have a great day.